and welcome. My name is Mark Brown. I'm a program manager on the Azure Cosmos DB team. In this video, I'm going to walk you through consistency models in Azure Cosmos DB. First, to get started, I want to define what consistency means in a distributed NoSQL database like Cosmos DB. For many people, consistency is the C in ACID, like what you'd see in a relational database in the context of a transaction. But for a distributed NoSQL database like Cosmos DB, this is not what we mean. So if consistency is not part of an ACID transaction, then what is it? Well, in a distributed database, consistency describes the uniformity of data for replicas connected by a network. In some cases, this data can be separated by hundreds or even thousands of miles. A consistency model is a contract that describes how and when data is copied and committed into other replicas. A consistency model must be predictable and provide clear consistency guarantees such that a developer clearly understands how data behaves in the system. Lastly, because a distributed database relies on a network, users are bound by the trade-offs imposed by CAP and PacLC theorems. This means that choices in consistency model has an impact on availability, latency, and throughput in your applications. Okay, so let's walk through each of the consistency models in Cosmos DB. Cosmos DB provides five consistency models to choose from, including strong, bounded staleness, session, consistent prefix, and eventual. Let's take a more detailed look at each of these. Strong consistency is the strictest consistency model. Data written using strong consistency is synchronously replicated to every replica in the database. This means that reads in every replica are guaranteed to return the most recent committed version of an item. Strong consistency is typically used in scenarios where an application cannot tolerate any data loss should a region become unavailable. And applications using strong consistency with two or more regions will get an RPO of 0. Of course, you don't get this for free. The trade-off is very large increases in latency, as every write must be replicated and committed to additional replicas before it is recognized as committed in the database. And the longer the distance between the replicas, the longer the latency for each write. Next is bounded staleness. In this consistency model, data is replicated asynchronously, with a predetermined staleness window defined by a number of writes or a period of time. And as the staleness window approaches, Cosmos will apply back pressure on writes to allow replication to catch up. Data outside of the staleness window is guaranteed to be globally consistent. Reads made inside of the staleness window within the same region will see strong consistency. Readers in different regions will see updates in the order in which they are made. This is better known as consistent prefix guarantees. The next level of consistency is session. Session is a unique consistency model in that it is client-centric, not data-centric as the others are. For applications with a single client or multiple clients sharing the same session token, reads are guaranteed to honor the consistent prefix and, in fact, will functionally get strong consistency. Clients outside the session, where all writes go to a single region, will see consistent prefix guarantees. Next is consistent prefix. With consistent prefix, this consistency level guarantees that readers will never see out-of-order writes. Consistent prefix provides write latencies, availability, and read throughput comparable to that of eventual consistency, but also provides the order guarantees that suit the needs of scenarios where order is important. And lastly is eventual. And as the name implies, there's no ordering guarantee for reads, and eventually the replicas will converge as consistent. Eventual consistency is the weakest form of consistency and is ideal where the application does not require any ordering guarantees. Examples of this include things like counting retweets or likes or non-threaded comments in a blog. Eventual consistency is also ideal where applications need to optimize for extreme throughput. So you can see consistency models are a trade-off for consistent data within a distributed database. And as with everything in distributed computing, those trade-offs also include trade-offs in higher or lower latency and higher or lower throughput. To learn more about consistency in Cosmos DB, visit https://aka.ms/cosmos-consistency-levels. Also, feel free to check out these other links to learn more about replication and high availability in Cosmos DB. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video.